Do you like sheep? Do you like sheep that have uncomfortable relationships with human beings? If so, I guess you're in the right place. Is brought to us by director Valdemar, not gonna make the joke, Johansson, and stars Naomi Rapace and Hilner Snær Gudensson. Sure, I nailed that name. So Lamb is a new A24 movie, and if you know anything about A24, you know that this is gonna get a bit odd. And it does definitely get odd. However, I will admit that it doesn't get quite as odd as I initially thought it would. At least some of it doesn't. Our story is about a sheep herder husband and wife named Maria and Ingvar. They live in the mountains in Iceland, and they herd sheep for a living. I know, shocker. We also find that they at one point in time had a daughter and unfortunately lost that daughter. And I don't mean they like lost her at Walmart or something, I mean like she passed away. Now one day one of their sheep gives birth to a lamb, but this lamb is a little bit different than the other lambs. I'm not spoiling anything here because it is more or less in the trailer, but this lamb is somehow half lamb, half human. Which opens up a whole lot of questions as far as what the husband is doing with his free time. Upon making this miraculous discovery, they decide to take this lamb into their home and more or less raise it as their child, Ada. Now some of the other sheep, they're not in love with this idea, and it does become a little bit difficult to explain the situation to human beings as well. But hey, Maria and Ingvar, they're living their best life. They don't really care about what everybody else thinks. They've got their daughter back and they're being happy. Of course, it doesn't just end there. There is more, but I don't want to spoil anything. Just know that things get kind of out there at times. Now, as out there as that premise sounds, which yes, it is, it doesn't just sound that way, it is pretty fucking out there. Overall, the movie's not that weird. It is more or less about grief and loss and how we as people deal with that. You have two people that lost a child, and I couldn't even begin to imagine that, and what that does to a person when they're given another opportunity to have at least some of that back, they latch onto it. And while there is a layer of depression that blankets over this entire film, there are some genuinely happy moments that come up as well. Who the hell are we to say that these people can't raise this human sheep hybrid monster thing as their kid? I mean, it's making them happy and it ain't hurting nobody. All jokes aside, you actually do start to want this situation to work out for everybody that's involved. Sure, there's a mutant animal baby that they're trying to raise as their own, and it is a bit weird, but you truly do see that it's making them happy, so you want this to work out. But this is in the vein of an old school folktale, so the ending is in line with that as well. There's a constant feeling of foreboding in this film, like something is about to happen, something is coming, and it ain't good. Now I ain't gonna lie, this story didn't like blow me away, but it is extremely well done and I just couldn't stop watching it. They took a premise that could have been comical as hell and they made it work. You actually do feel for all these characters, including Ada, the mutant human sheep hybrid thing. Overall, any shortcomings in the narrative are definitely made up in other areas in this movie, and I had a pretty good time with the story here. Though, as with all movies of this kind, it ain't gonna be for everybody. Now, say what you will about the odd little story that they're telling here, the performances are absolutely fantastic. Naomi Rapace once again shows us that she is not in enough movies. She is wonderful as Maria. This movie doesn't have like a whole lot of dialogue. There's actually long stretches of time that nothing is ever said, but you can just read everything that's going on with her as a character in her face. I make the joke a lot of the times about acting performances not being a tour de force in my reviews and stuff. This though, this is an absolute tour de force. At this point, the question I have is not if Naomi Rapace will ever get an Oscar, but when she will get her Oscar. Because she continues to just be amazing in everything she's in, and this is probably one of her best roles to date. But don't let that take away from the other performances in the film. Gudensson as Ingvar is pretty damn good as well. Much like the character of Maria, you read more from his body language and his facial expressions than anything that ever comes out of his mouth. The love that these two display for this child that they have is genuine as hell. I mean, if I didn't know any better, I'd say that's a real hybrid kid and they have taken it in as their own. The movie probably won't be nominated for any acting achievement awards, but damn it, it should be. Something else that you'll notice right off the bat with this movie is that it is just gorgeous. Like, every shot of this movie is a beautiful work of art. This is some great cinematography where they let the beautiful area that they're in do all the talking. And while there is a lot of that, and it is absolutely gorgeous, it's not just that. Even the stuff like inside the house, when we have two characters talking, it's just done extremely well. Something else that's done extremely well is the effects in the movie. This doesn't seem like it would be an effects heavy movie, but it kinda is. I mean, it's not like Avengers Endgame or anything, but there are a fair amount of effects here, and more importantly, you don't really notice it. The only reason you know these are effects is because these kind of things just don't exist. I don't think they do, at least. I hope they don't. You believe these things that you see on screen. I do think that it was a bit of a mix between practical and CGI, but both look fantastic, and sometimes you just can't tell which is which. Guys, I found Lamb to be very moving, emotional, and oddly entertaining. Its story is, at its heart, fairly simple, but that's not what's so interesting about this thing. It's the characters. You really get to know these people. You care about them, and you see happiness on the horizon. And you want that happiness to sustain, but you know, because of the foreboding feel throughout the entire thing, that it's probably just not. It's a gorgeous film with absolutely fantastic performances that is absolutely worth a rent.
All he wanted was this.
I have to return some videotape.
I kind of like this movie more and more as time goes on. I just watched it last night, but I like it more now than I did then. So by the time I get to the end of the year, this might be in my top 10, who knows? So if you're looking for a really interesting, entertaining, yet odd, and at times kind of heartbreaking film to watch for the night, then check out Lamb, and I think you'll at best have a really interesting and odd time with it. So there it is, guys, my review of Lamb. If you enjoyed and want more content like this, hit that subscribe button and help my little channel grow. If you want to help out the channel, check out my Patreon in the description below and become a Jarhead and get some of the awesome benefits to go along with that, like these guys. And possibly join my top tier and become a bad motherfucker like my man Greg. If you liked what I had to say, give me a like. If not, let me know in the comments below why. And as always, stay sexy, Keflavik. While this movie is definitely odd, by A24 standards, it is definitely not the oddest out there. And while this one is great and I absolutely recommend checking it out, if you want something like truly odd that comes from A24, then check out The Lighthouse. You've probably at least heard of this movie, but just believe me now, it's not even really a movie, it's more like an experience. A really, really just weird out there fucking experience.
I want a steak!
If I had a steak, I would fuck it.
I seen it. Ye finding me lobster.